ভারতের প্রধানমন্ত্রী নরেন্দ্র মোদীর আহ্বানে সার্কভুক্ত দেশের প্রধানদের ভিডিও কনফারেন্সে গণভবন থেকে যোগ দিয়েছেন প্রধানমন্ত্রী শেখ হাসিনা। আমরা এখন সরাসরি চলে যাচ্ছি সেখানে।
Is His Excellency Isala Virakun, Secretary General of the SAARC. To begin the program, I have the honor to invite the Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi ji, for his introductory remarks and thereafter for conducting the proceedings.
Excellencies, Namaskar. I would like to thank you all for joining this special interaction. I especially thank our friend Prime Minister Oli, who had joined us almost immediately after his recent surgery. I wish him a speedy recovery. I would also like to congratulate President Ashraf Ghani for his recent re-election. I welcome the new Secretary General of SAARC, who is also with us today. I also acknowledge the presence of the Director of the SAARC Disaster Management Center from Gandhinagar. Excellencies, as we all know, COVID-19 has recently been classified by the World Health Organization, WHO, as a pandemic. So far, our SAARC region has listed fewer than 150 cases, but we need to remain vigilant. Our SAARC region is home to nearly one-fifth of all humanity. It is densely populated. As developing countries, all of us have significant challenges in terms of access to healthcare facilities. Our people-to-people ties are ancient, and our societies are deeply interconnected. Therefore, we must all prepare together. We must all act together, and we must all succeed together. Excellencies, as we prepare to face this challenge, let me briefly share India's experience of combating the spread of this virus so far. Prepare, but do not panic, has been our guiding mantra. We were careful to not underestimate the problem, but also to avoid knee-jerk reactions. We have tried to take proactive steps, including a graded response mechanism. We started screening entry into India from mid-January itself, while also gradually increasing restrictions on travel. The step-by-step approach has helped avoid panic. We have increased our public awareness campaigns on TV, print and social media. We have made special efforts to reach out to vulnerable groups. We have worked to quickly ramp up capacity in our system, including through training our medical staff across the country. We have also increased diagnostic capabilities. Within 2 months, we moved from one major facility for pan-India testing to more than 66 such labs, and we have developed protocols for each stage of managing this pandemic. For screening at entry points, contact tracing of suspected cases, quarantine and management of isolation facilities, and for discharge of cleared cases. We also responded to the call of our people abroad. We evacuated nearly 1,400 Indians from different countries. We also similarly helped some of the citizens of our neighboring countries. We have now built a protocol for such evacuations, including carrying out testing by our mobile teams deployed abroad. We recognize that other countries would be also concerned about their citizens in India. So, we brief foreign ambassadors about the steps we were taking. Excellencies, we fully recognize that we are still in an unknown situation. We cannot predict with certainty how the situation will unfold despite our best efforts. You must also be facing similar concerns. This is why it would be most valuable for all of us to share our perspectives. I look forward to hearing your views. Thank you very much. I now request His Excellency President Ghani to share his thoughts with us.
Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister, and best wishes to Prime Minister Oli, and thank you for taking this very important initiative. All that is normal is disrupted, and all that seems solid is melting into thin air. We are into unknown territory, and our vulnerability, Excellency, comes from our openness. Our greatest vulnerability is that we have an open border with Iran, one of the major centers, and the flow cannot be stopped. And the province of Herat has become the central node for preventing the spread and diffusion of this deadly disease to the rest of South Asia. I have the following five proposals. One, modeling of diffusion impacts and scenarios for management. Unless we model the diffusion, we will be facing assumptions from China or the United States or Iran are not suitable to our situation. I request the task force of SARC to be able to do this. Second, telemedicine, because the second and third order impact of this, particularly on poor and vulnerable and women, is very significant. If we could create a common framework for telemedicine for diagnosis of related issues, and as advances take place, how to be able to coordinate. Third, as a landlocked country, which is simultaneously the heart of Asia, closing of borders while essential will result in significant problems regarding availability of medicine, food, and basic goods. Can we coordinate to be able to create controlled flows that both allows transactions to take place while focusing on the essentials. The fourth issue for us, excellencies, because in all excellency, because we have cancelled schools, prayers have been stopped. How do we keep women, youth, and children occupied? Since India in particular and South Asia are leaders in distance education and self-learning, can the SARC satellite and India satellite be made available so we can keep people, because social distancing that is necessary cannot just take place. And my fifth proposal, Prime Minister, distinguished Prime Minister, since India is both a very important member of SARC and a member of the Shanghai Council, Cooperation Council, in Shanghai, both with China, that is our deepest sympathies, in Iran, can we coordinate between SARC and the Shanghai Cooperation Council to your initiative? How much of the experience of China is replicable to our situations, and how do we both learn and help Iran? I thank you again for this opportunity. Our conditions, being one of the poorest countries and conflict prone, require learning, particularly from how you upscale the existing program. We have a program across the country called HELP, that is basic help. And if there are other countries that have upgraded their basic systems to cope with this, we'd be extremely grateful for learning and yet sharing our experience. Thank you, Excellency.
Thank you, Excellency. I now request His Excellency President Soli to make his remarks.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good afternoon. I too wish to begin by thanking Prime Minister Modi for this timely call for a regional initiative to combat the increasing threat of COVID-19 in the SAARC region. In times of crisis, we do come together. In 2003, for example, when the region faced the threat of SARS, the Maldives took the initiative and hosted an extraordinary meeting of SAARC health ministers that adopted a regional common strategy for tackling the virus. No country on its own can succeed in combating the virus. It requires a shared response at an unprecedented scale. The first COVID-19 case was confirmed in the Maldives on 7 March. To date, there are 13 confirmed cases. Fortunately, no deaths so far. Since January this year, the Maldives has been taking steps to get ready for a possible outbreak. We set in place standard operational procedures and facilities for treatment and quarantine in various islands. In the event of major outbreak in the country, our health facilities will have to cope with the care needed for both our residents and the thousands of tourists who visit the Maldives every year. Our priority now is to use precautionary measures to contain the virus as much as possible so as not to overburden our limited resources. The unique geography of the Maldives will always present itself both as an opportunity as well as a challenge. The dispersed islands make it easier for us to isolate communities whenever there is a suspected case. But in the event that a person tests positive in the outer islands and is seriously ill, requiring specialist care, the person has to be transported to the capital, Male. This is extremely costly and puts enormous pressure on an overstretched team of healthcare workers. Our tertiary hospitals in the regions are currently under development. Shortage of healthcare professionals in general and shortage of specialist doctors in particular are always major challenges. And in a crisis such as this, these challenges are several times greater. The Maldives is fortunate to have received general assistance from India, and I convey my government's appreciations to Prime Minister Modi and the people of India. We have received medicine and a visiting medical relief team to work with Maldivian healthcare professionals. Excellencies, in the Maldives, the virus is showing in the most destructive measure the country's vulnerabilities to external shocks. Tourist arrivals started to decline considerably several weeks before the first case was reported. In February this year, arrivals declined by 14.3%. And in the first 10 days of this month,
করোনাভাইরাস ইস্যুতে ভারতের প্রধানমন্ত্রী নরেন্দ্র মোদীর আহ্বানে সার্কভুক্ত দেশের প্রধানদের ভিডিও কনফারেন্স গণভবন থেকে যোগ দিয়েছিলেন প্রধানমন্ত্রী শেখ হাসিনা। আমরা এতক্ষণ ছিলাম সেখানে।